In this video, I will derive the standard form, the vertex form of the quadratic equation from the factor form, and as well as graphing the quadratic equation. So we have a factor form of this quadratic equation, y equals x minus 2 times x plus 6. So let's do the standard form first. And to find the standard form, all we need to do is just expand it. So let's start with the standard form of this quadratic equation. So let's expand this. Y equals, okay, x times x is x squared, x times 6 is plus 6x, negative 2 times x is negative 2x, negative 2 plus negative 2 times 6 is negative 12. So y equals 2. Now we group the like terms, x squared plus 4x minus 12. This is the standard form of this equation. So what is the vertex form? How do we find the vertex form? So for vertex form, it has a standard equation, y equals to a times x minus h squared plus k. So this is the vertex form. So the vertex can be seen from this equation, which is the point h and k. H is the x value and k is the y value. That's the vertex point. But how do we find the vertex point from a standard form? We have this equation here. We have this formula here. X, this is the x value of the vertex form, negative b over 2a. So, what is b, what is a? All quadratic equation takes the form of y equals to ax squared plus bx plus c. In this case, based on the standard form, a is 1, b is 4, and c is equal to negative 12. So let's plug in this formula to find the x value of the vertex point. Negative b, negative 4, divided by 2 times a is 1. So this is negative 4 over 2, which is negative 2. Negative 2. So the x value of this vertex form, of this vertex point. How do we get the y value of the vertex point? We just need to put the 2 into the x here in the standard form, and we can get the y value of the vertex form. So let me try this. Y equals to, so this is negative 2 squared plus 4 times negative 2 minus 12. And what is that equal to? Negative 2 squared is 4. 4 minus a is negative 4 minus 12, negative 16. So the vertex point of this quadratic equation should be negative 2 and negative 16. Okay, if that's the case, I can write the vertex form. So this is vertex form. Which will be based on this form. We have h is negative 2 and k is negative 16. So we will have to write that as y equals to a times, we don't know what a is, x minus h. Now, minus h is negative 2. So minus negative 2 is plus 2 squared. Now plus k, plus negative 16, minus 16. The next thing is we need to figure out what a is. In order to figure out what a is, we just need to pick another point in this quadratic equation. Make sure you don't use the same point as what we have used for the vertex. For example, just don't use the vertex point again. So what point can we use? Look at this factor form here. we actually have 2 points already that we haven't used, which are the zeros, the x-intercepts. So you will have 2, 0 and -6, 0. You can use either of this point to find out what a is. Let me use 2 zeros. So we'll plug in 2, 0. So 0 is y, so y is equal to now a, so 0 is equal to a times x is 2 plus 2 square minus 16. 0 is equal to, okay, 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 squared 16. 16a minus 16. Add 16 to both sides, you have 16 equal to 16a. Divide both sides by 16 to isolate a. A is equal to 1. So we can put 1 into this and we will finish our vertex form. So basically the vertex form is y equals to 1. 1 times x plus 2 square minus 16. So this is the vertex form. Now, there's another way to derive the vertex form. So we have this standard form. How do we get the vertex form? We can complete the square. That's another way to get the vertex form. So let's do this. Now complete the square. For vertex form. So recall what the standard form was, x squared plus 4x minus 12. So we have y equals to x squared plus 4x minus 12. So let that equal to 0. We're actually, by doing that, we're actually trying to find the zeros, basically it's x-intercept when we do this. But we're not looking for the x-intercept, we just want to complete the square to get the vertex form this time. So add 12 to both sides, that's what we have to do. Equals to 12. Since the leading coefficient here is 1, so we're good to do that. Now, x squared plus 4x, we have to add the number to both sides. And the number is the same number. What would the number be? It's always the middle term. Divide by 2 and then square. So that is 4 divided by 2 square, which is 2 square, which is 4. So we add 4, we add 4. And we can write this side as, we keep the left side the same. The right side is 12 plus 4, 16. And the left side is a perfect square now. So we can write it as x something square equals to 16. So is it plus or minus something? It's always the middle coefficient divided by 2. So basically it's 4 divided by 2 is 2. So we're plus 2 and we're done. So let's move the 16 to the left side. So we have x plus 2 square minus 16 equal to 0. And we can call this y. So basically we have y equals to x plus 2 square minus 16. So this is the form after completing the square. Let me write this better. Now, take a look at this form. and take a look at this form. This is exactly the same, and that is the vertex form, and it's derived by finding the value using the standard form, deriving from the standard form. And this is the same vertex form derived by completing the square on the standard form. Now, next, I will graph this quadratic equation. So graph the quadratic equation and see how it looks like. Let me draw a Cartesian plan. Well, since the vertex is at -2 and 16, so I will increase the value by 2. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is Y, this is X. So let's start with the vertex. What was the vertex form? So the vertex form was -2, -16. I should label this first. So this is 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. -2, -4, -6, -8, -10, -12, -14, -16. So same here, -2, -4, -6, -8, -10, -12, -14, -16, -18, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. So incremental of 2. So vertex form, -2 and -16. So let me see. X is -2 and Y is -16, so we'll be here. This is the vertex. And we definitely have the zeros, which is 2 and -6. So 2 and -6. Any other points do we have? I think we only look for like 3 points. You already have idea how this point looks like, how this graph will look like. But you're supposed to actually look for like 2 more points in the vicinity of the vertex on the left side and the right side. You can do that by taking, let's say, -4, x = -4 or x = 0. But we know that when x = 0, you get a y-intercept. Then we can try this. So y-intercept, let's do it here. y = 0 - 2 times 0 + 6. So y = -2 times 6. y = -12. And that's y-intercept. So we have another point here. Y-intercept is negative 12. So we can join the graph now. So it's a rough sketch. I will try my best to join it. So this side is the same. It goes up like this. So that's how the graph looks like. So you can actually derive the standard form and the vertex form of the quadratic equation from the factor form. And from the standard form, all you need to do is just expand it and collect the items. For vertex form, you can expand to standard form and then use the formula, which is this one. X equals to negative b divided by 2a to get the x value of the vertex, and then plug the x value of the vertex into the original equation to find the y value of the vertex. Or you can just complete the square on the standard form of the equation. Hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.